Today I'm going to be talking about Chegg Tutors. Probably this is the first video on the internet guiding you about how to enroll yourself into Chegg Tutors. I will be putting up a screen recording of the entire process and how to go about it. So watch this video till the end. The process is very simple. There are a couple of steps that you will have to follow. I will be taking you to the website and I will be teaching you in the screen recording all the steps that you have to follow, okay? And mind it, please take it seriously because this can be a major source of income. All right. And there are so many ways you can be actually making money through Chegg, but I will only be covering tutoring today. My another video on becoming a Chegg expert has quite been popular with you people. And this is why I take the opportunity of actually taking you to another domain of Chegg where you interact with students. Quite recently, I filled up the form of Chegg Tutors and there were roughly 5 steps to it. And after completing those 5 steps, what you had to do was you have to pick a slot of interview for yourself. And before you pick a slot of interview for yourself, what you have to do is you will have to pick somebody on the panel who will be interviewing you. In my case, how it happened was, I will tell you, I picked up somebody who I wanted to interview me. All right, I picked up a slot. But eventually, when I went online for the interview, it was supposed to be a 15-minute interview. Okay, when I started off with the interview, it was supposed to be between 2 people. I should have been able to see that person, but somehow his camera was not working. So he could see me, I could not see him. And another thing that happened was that that person whom I had selected could not turn up. So somebody else turned up in his place and he interviewed me. The questions which he asked me were very basic and very, very simple. And trust me, there was not even a single question I did not know the answer to. So if you know the basics of your subject, you will be able to handle the interview very easily. I mean, that is how it went for me. I don't know, questions might be different in your case because the person interviewing you might be different. Okay, so this is it. Apart from that, the interview lasted around 15 minutes and it was good, and the person was also very friendly. He was good, and then they told me that they will be getting back to me, and then they responded in another 3 to 4 days where they emailed me and they told me that I've been selected. I have the notes with me. I've written down the questions that were asked to me because otherwise I would not be able to remember them. I selected the subject accountancy. There are too many subjects on the list, roughly 15 to 20 subjects. You can pick any of them for yourself. And they asked me about bank reconciliation statement. Then they asked me the 3 golden rules of accountancy. They also asked me the various financial statements which are prepared for a company. Then they asked me about the corporation form of company. Okay, they asked me about the cash book. Why is it prepared? And they asked me the written down value method of depreciation. So if you have any background of accountancy, you would know that these are the most basic things a person from that background should know. So of course, I could handle all of them because this is like nothing. These questions are so simple. They pay you $20 for 1 hour and you don't have to be present for 1 complete hour at a stretch. So what happens is the minutes in your account, they get accumulated in your profile, okay? And all those minutes are of course converted into hours and you are paid according to the number of hours you have worked in a week. And let me warn you, these guidelines are as of now. Things change, okay? So things might change in the future. This video is only about what's happening right now, okay? This might get a little different from now in the next 3-4 months or maybe in a year, okay? Apart from that, your profile is visible to the students. You will have to take care that you are providing good service because otherwise your rating will go down and students will get to know that whether this person is worthy enough to be tutoring me or not. So you would want to maintain your dignity by working well and by providing proper education and properly doing your research before you actually provide an answer to a student. Okay, I will try and put up as much valid information as I can. Please go through the video and let me know if there is more you would want to ask me. Okay, I will be available on the email ID alinaraislive@gmail.com. Please follow me on Instagram on the handle alina_rais_insta. And as you know, I will definitely get back to you on all your requests. Okay, so let's get started with the screen recording. I will simply write apply to Chegg Tutors. Okay. And this is the first link right on the top. I'm going to click it. So this is the website and it says right on the top, become a tutor. I'm going to be clicking on this. Actually, you don't need to click because this is the correct page that has opened up. Just simply click sign up right here. And then you have this little window popping up saying create an account. I will simply use my name. Okay. This is the page that opens up, which is of most relevance to you. As you can see, they will ask you to upload your photo also. Then there are certain other requirements. They will be asking you about your school, which you've attended, your graduation year, your majors, country of residence. There's one question that I keep getting off and on is what to upload under English proficiency certificate. Guys, I used my class 12th mark sheet in that requirement. So maybe that would be helpful for you. Just simply upload the last exam that you have given off English and upload the mark sheet. I think this will be good to go. And in case you face any further issues, you can always write me an email. Anyway, I will get started over here. This is the first page. These are the registration steps, which says right on the top. You have the basic information that you need to fill in. Once you fill in your basic info, that is when the next tab of choose subjects that is going to open up. And then you have the tell us about yourself information. Then you have the verification of your identity and finally verification of your qualifications. One little tip over here, in case your application is rejected, I think it worked for me. Maybe you can use another email ID and follow the process all over again. So I don't think it will allow me to go to the next page unless I fill up the information. And I think you are capable enough to go through the process on your own. These are the 5 steps that you need to follow. I'm highlighting over here. Okay, just simply follow these steps and they will be accepting your application. And then they will be going through the information that you've provided. They will ask you to schedule an interview for yourself. Pick up a slot, pick up a tutor you would want to interview with and go ahead with your interview, and all the best. This is it. By the way, before I close down on the video, just one little thing I would want to highlight here. Do you have a US ID, US tax ID? Just simply click no. Okay, because obviously you don't have one if you're an Indian, so you will have to check this one. Okay, this is it. And rest is very, very simple. All right. Bye.